Okay, everyone, please again pause and read the question. But maybe let me go through some few things. So you see that we are given the demand, right? Inverse demand. Okay, inverse demand. And please keep in mind that when you have a car inverse demand like this, what you also know is your marginal revenue, right? Which is equal to this one. You know immediately your marginal revenue when the inverse demand is linear. Anyway, the key thing is that we have two plants, and the first plant we have marginal cost that look like this, and the second plant we have marginal that cost that look like this. So the question asks you to find how much you should produce in total, and again, how to allocate resource between the two plants. Everyone, first, you don't, as I said here, I give you some hint. You have to invert MC to QMC. Okay. What do we mean by QMC? So this is marginal cost as a function of quantity, right? This is what we are given, okay? Marginal cost as a function of quantity. But we have to convert into this one. This is quantity as a function of marginal cost, okay? So the reason that we have to do this is because of the horizontal summation. Everyone, let me just quickly show you, okay? You don't need to write this down. But right now we have, if you plus the MC1 and MC2 together, you see that the MC curve will look something like this. So if you kind of plus them together, it will be a vertical summation, everyone. It will be a vertical summation. And we don't usually do the vertical summation in this case. The reason is because we don't want to, because the vertical summation is when you want to add up the price together, but not this time, right? We don't want to add up the price. We want to add up the quantity. We want to make sure that Q1, Q2 add up to Q star. So that's why we have to convert this marginal cost as a function of quantity to quantity as a function of marginal cost. So let's see. So everyone, in the first step, you have to, as I said, you have to convert. You have to find the marginal cost of the whole monopoly, okay, the total marginal cost. So everyone, we are given MC1, we are given MC2, right? And now, as I said, you have to convert it into the quantity as a function of marginal cost. So that's how you do it. Very simple, right? And now, after you get Q1 and Q2, you can do the horizontal summation. Right, you can do the horizontal summation Q1 plus Q2 equal to Qt here. Everyone notice what I did here. This equation goes here. But you see that I change my subscript. This is MC1, I change it to MCT. This is MC2, I change to MCT. Why? How can I do that? Why? The reason is because, as I said, everyone, when you do the horizontal summation, look, when you do the horizontal summation, your intercept on the y-axis is fixed, okay? Your intercept on the y, actually, I should not use the word intercept, sorry. Your value on the y-axis must be fixed. So in this case, I'm going to fix at MCT, right? So that's why I could write MCT in place of MC1, MCT in place of MC2 here. The reason is because, again, we fix the price together, right? Because we want to find the horizontal summation. Now we fix the price, we fix the value on the y-axis at MCT, and then you can add this up. You can find QT, you can find Qt by adding Q1 and Q2, you get Qt. And okay, after I do this, oops, that's so, oh, okay, lucky me. So everyone, when you do this, you can, okay, you get this Q. Once again, I have to turn off the, okay, anyway. So when you solve this thing together, when you solve this thing up, this is what you are going to get, everyone. Qt equal to this number, right? And you can revert back to this one, okay? You can revert back to your standard marginal cost of the monopoly, right? So when you have this marginal cost of the monopoly, now you can equate with MR, right? Of course, everyone, now we get this line. Oh, once again, we get this line, everyone, we get this line. So the next thing is to find MR and to find this quantity here. I have MR already. I told you that I can use the formula. I have my demand curve and I know that my MR will be twice as steep as the inverse demand. Okay, twice as steep as the inverse demand. So that's what I get. I equate MC and MR. So what I get is my total quantity is 7, everyone. This is the output that the whole monopolist should produce. The total output, okay? The total output. Once again, everyone, this total output will be allocated between the two firms. Not the two firms, the two plants. So now, the next step is to find this, how should we allocate among the plants. So again, we use this condition as I told you earlier. Okay, in case you forgot, everyone, again, we will find the MR at this point, right? And then you see where it intercepts with the MC at each plant. The concept here, in case you may want to understand the concept here, think about this. We usually say, let me add some page. So usually everyone, when your MR is, let's say 5, for example, and if your MC is 4, for example, in this case, you should produce more, right? You should produce more. But if your MC is 6, then you should produce less, right? Again, it's follow the same logic. Marginal revenue, what does it mean? Additional revenue from producing one more unit. Additional cost from producing one more unit. If it's greater than you should, if MR is greater than MC, as I said, you should produce more. If it's less than, you should produce less. Again, this is the concept is quite the same. If your MR, which is the marginal revenue of the whole market, exceed the MC, maybe MC1 or MC2, it means that you are not maximizing your profit yet, right? Again, it just means you're not maximizing profit yet. So that's why your MR must be equal to MC of each plant. And more importantly, I explained to you earlier that the MC of each plant must be equal, right? Must be equal. If they are not equal, then you should relocate your production. If MC1 is 5, MC2 is 10, as I said, it means that you should produce more in 10 watt, in plant 1. That's what this topic. Did I say something wrong? Yes, I did say something wrong. Sorry, everyone. If MC1 is 5, oh no, I was correct. Sorry. If MC1 is 5, MC2 is 10, it means it's expensive here. You should not produce at plant 2. You should allocate production in plant 1. Sorry for my mistake. Anyway, so to find this Q star 1, Q star 2, of course you have to use this condition. So let's let's do this. Everyone, we know already, we know this one, right? We know this one. We know MR as well. So you actually plug this in, right? You plug this in and what you get is this one, right? So that's what I did here. So first of all, I have MR, right? I also have Q10. So I plug this in, I got MR equal to 78. And the condition, everyone, the condition is that the marginal cost of firm one producing the quantity, its quantity of the plant one must be equal to the marginal revenue of the whole firm. Okay, so MI is 78. So MC1, everyone, in case you may forget, MC1 come from this one, come from your the question. Okay, MC1 equal to 10 plus 20 Q1. Okay, MC1, 10 plus 20 Q1. You plug in the Q1 there, you get Q equal to this one. Everyone, you see that you can do the same to solve for Q2 here. And everyone, finally, the sum of Q1 and Q2 here equal to 7, as we want. Okay, I guess that's all about the hard part. Everyone, next is the a cartel. Okay, when you cartel, what do we mean by a cartel? First of all, cartel is a group of firm. Okay, group of firm, but you kind of collude. Collude means in Thai mean รวมหัวนะครับ รวมหัวนะ so you kind of act together as one. Okay, you are a group of firm, but you act together as one. So you act as a single monopoly firm. Okay, and what you do is you talk, you negotiate with each other to determine the price of output of the market in order to maximize everyone profit, right? Maximize the monopoly. I mean the cartel profit. Okay, everyone, example of the cartel is the OPEC country. OPEC country is like Saudi Arabia, Kuwait, and maybe Iran or whatever. So this guy are the oil exporting country. Okay, so what they do is they control the oil production. They control the oil production. So this is to kind of control the oil price of the world, of the whole world. In case for those who already study the macroeconomic, you have heard about the oil price shock, right? Oil price shock. You have a supply shock, and this oil price shock is usually caused by the OPEC country or the cartel, the oil cartel. So everyone, as I said, the cartel will act as a single monopoly, and they will kind of allocate their production similar to this problem that we are currently studying, the multi-plant monopolist. So here in this case of multi-plant monopolist, you have the MC of plant 1, MC of plant 2, right? And but in the case of cartel, you are going to have the MC of one country, MC of firm, okay, one firm, second firm. And again, if your firm is kind of efficient, okay, efficient means you have lower cost, like this MC2 here, plant 2 here or firm 2 here has lower cost, so you can produce more, everyone. And it, of course, when you produce more, you get more portion of profit. Okay, cartel is going to maximize the total profit, and then they pay the profit to each firm. Okay, they act as a single monopolist to maximize the profit of a cartel, and then they divide this profit in for a smaller firm. For the cartel member, And everyone, this allocation of output and the profit is again based on the marginal cost. I guess that's all for this topic. Thank you for your attention.